Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's look at a new feature in Keynote that allows you to play video and audio across slides. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So Keynote version 10.1 has a new feature that allows you to place video and audio on slides like before. But if the same video or audio exists on the next slide, you can choose to have the video or audio continue to play from one slide to the next. So this is a feature in 10.1, so make sure you've updated to the latest version. As an example here, I've placed a video on this slide. Now typically if I were to create a new slide here, I would just have that video on the one slide. So I could play that video on the one slide and then continue to the next slide without the video. But now if I were to select this, copy it, paste it onto the next slide so the video existed in both places. Now when I select the video under Format Movie, I can choose the option Play Movie Across Slides. So let's put some things on these slides so we can tell them apart. So now we've got two different slides here. Let's play this. I'm going to use another new feature in Keynote, and that's the ability to play but in the window so it's not going to take over the screen. Now here I can see slide one. I'll click on the video to start it and there are the waves crashing down. If I go to the next slide by clicking, you can see the video is uninterrupted but I've advanced to the next slide. So you can use this to have a series of slides while the same video plays. And you can also set the slides to advance automatically, not on a click. The way you do that, of course, is select the slide, go to Animate, Transitions, and you start the transition to the next slide automatically after a delay of a certain number of seconds. So here's another example. This has a video of me talking about something. And then I've got three slides after that with some captions underneath. So I want the video to keep going for each of these slides. I'm going to select the video and then I'm going to go to Format Movie and make sure Play Movie Across Slides is checked. Then I'm also going to uncheck Start Movie on Click. I want it to start automatically. Now the next thing I want to do is copy the video and then paste it on each of these slides. Now I could just play this here and advance the slides manually when it gets to the right point. But I could also have it do it automatically. So I happen to know that the first caption should appear after 3 seconds. So what I can do here is under Animate Transitions for the slide, I can say Start Transmission Automatically after 3 seconds. On the next slide, I can say Start it automatically after 2 seconds, which is when I get to the next point. And then on this slide, go automatically to the next one after 3 seconds. I simply got these timings by watching the video in QuickTime Player and noting where each point was that I wanted and jotting them down. So now when I play this, it'll advance to the next slide at the right point.
The Centers for Disease Control recommends that you wash your hands frequently, avoid close contact with others, and wear a mask when in public.
So you can see how handy that could be. You could actually put together videos kind of like the ones I do by recording yourself talking, putting this video down in a corner or something, and building a series of slides to travel through while that video plays. You could even change the position of the video. So for instance, I could, you know, position it here, here, and here, and it will work when I try it.
The Centers for Disease Control recommends that you wash your hands frequently, avoid close contact with others, and wear a mask when in public.
Now, of course, I didn't place them anywhere specific, but you can imagine actually moving the video to a different corner of the screen to just make it visually interesting as you advance through the points that you're talking about. And you can even use a video as a background. I can stretch this video. It actually is full resolution here. And I can do it here on this slide as well. And then have it advance automatically after a few seconds to the next slide. And now it works as a background when I play it. Now you can do this with audio as well. So here's an example where you may use that. Say you've got some slides at the beginning of your presentation. So you have this introduction one here and you want that to be on the screen maybe for 5 minutes, and then it will go to this one and be there for 1 minute, and then this one and remain there until you click or press the space bar to start the real presentation on slide 4. It would be nice to have music playing across all three of these, but only these three slides, not as background music through your entire presentation. So I could drag and drop an MP3 file here to this slide and it appears here. I'll set it up under Format Audio to start audio automatically, so not wait. I'll have it repeat, so loop, and I'll have it play across slides. So what I'll do here is I'll take this, I'll copy it, and I'll paste it into these slides here. Now instead of 5 minutes and 1 minute, I just set these each to 3 seconds so I can demonstrate what goes on. And now it'll sit on this slide until I click, and then we'll go to slide 4. So with those examples, I'm kind of just scratching the surface with what we can do now, because we can probably come up with other creative things to do with playing video and audio across a series of slides instead of only just on one slide, or in the case of audio, having it play across the entire presentation. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.